Let's reduce some contact with the test. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Roger, Hawaii, read your lights clear also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, end of test.
Okay, we checked all four systems, and there you go on modulation, all four, and keying with a go.
Roger, your lights clear here also.
You know, one thing about when you're exploring with other people and you get the opportunity to, is that, you know, you cover more ground. And especially when you're in a place that you really don't know, you know, you can only see so much. And a lot of times what happens is you walk by something and then somebody else sees it, whether it be you or you see it and they didn't or whatever. You just cover more stuff. And so I got all the way over here to the unknown, which was a hell of a hike. Pretty miserable hike, really. They just called me and said, come back, man. We've got some massive petroglyphs that I'm definitely going to want to see. And you know, one of the things was I didn't walk the edge. And I'm telling you, I should have walked the edge. I should have walked the edge, and I didn't. Well, I've come over to this edge, and I really don't see anything. So we're going to work our way back over there. So close to the unknown one, but yet so far. You just can't hike all of them in a day. So we're going to work our way back across and see what's over here. See if these petroglyphs. So let's trace through the barren landscape. Sometimes this does suck. But I'm not in a cubicle today. So, yeah, there is some advantages doing this. Let's go back on over there. We're going to head back over to that cliff right over there. It looks simple and easy, except for the fact you got to go all the way around. But that's the way it is. It's always worth it if you find what you're looking for. You know, it never fails. Agua Fria never disappoints, ever. It never disappoints in the difficulty of the hike. It never disappoints in the quality of the terrain as far as the beauty. It never disappoints for the fact that, my gosh, you find stuff that just not everybody has seen. I mean, you know, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying by any means that we're even close to being the first people here. There's been hundreds, but you know, 100 people is not that many when you really think about locations. And then again, we might have found something that even if they came here, they didn't know anything about it, wouldn't have seen. So, you know, we're going to go back over, trace through this tall grass that I'm traipsing through. And hit every rock that's there that I can't see. That's been the ammo so far. That's the Agua Fria ammo, though. That's not just today. So trudge through here. Oh, it's like my track's right here. And we'll get back to that point. And hopefully what we'll see is some of the most ridiculously cool petroglyphs that we've ever seen on Agua Fria. Don't know that to be. I'm just trying to psych myself up. But I thought it was awful weird that we didn't see petroglyphs in this location because, you know, Agua Fria is famous for its petroglyphs. And to not see any was kind of unusual. You know, I should have known better, but I was so excited about the unknown area. And it's where we just came from. It's right over there to that point. I had to go around, do this, and then back over. And what was a simple hike, and I'll be honest with you, man, I was feeling awesome. We made it a job today, but we had to go see. I mean, you can't not know. You have to go see. So hopefully when we get down here, what we're going to see is some unbelievable petros. Well, we're almost here, man. We came from that point way over there. Doesn't look like a long way, but in Agua Fria miles, that's a long way. Look at that rock deformation right there. Isn't that unbelievable? It's crazy. You know, I'm working my way back over here. Came from that point over there. Working my way back this way. Now, they're over there. So what I'm doing is I'm looking on this way here. Because if they've got them there, are they all the way down here too? So what I'm doing is while I'm backtracking, I have to come this way anyway. I'm looking to see if there are any petroglyphs along the way. That way, you know, maybe there's some more down here. Now there's another trail right there. Look how predominant that trail is that goes down right there. And there's another cave right there. Isn't that incredible? So, you know, we got predators all over this valley. And, you know, we're very rural back here. You got everything back here. Everything that Arizona has to offer, we have here in this location. Look how beautiful that natural ledge is. And there's the predator sign over there. You know, we said that numerous times, that anywhere there's an area where a predator stays, that position of power, you seem to see signs of the ancients with petroglyphs. Pretty spectacular. Be a hell of a nice hike up that hill, wouldn't it? It's like an old ironwood tree. And those things are crazy, knowing that they could have been here 400 years ago, 500 years ago, maybe even longer. Look at that petroglyph there. That is another level. That is another level. And you wonder how many places there are like this where they have these stuck in these little crevices, you know, these special places to them that, you know, and that's why you got to kind of walk this ridge to try to see if they're back there, is there anything over here? You know, walking around that ledge and seeing if there's anything there. I don't see anything back there, but, you know, they could be all along this ridgeline. But there's really not a predominant trail that goes down there. So, well, I mean, it could be even over there. I doubt it. But let's go down and take a look. You guys ready? You ready to see what we've come all the way back over here to see? Hopefully it's going to be a beauty. So hopefully it'll get in the holy smokes category. But we'll go down and take a look. So the first thing we've seen right here on top of this hill, we do have a grinding hole right there. We do have a grinding hole. So somebody spent time up here either making tools or grinding corn. Maize that was up here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a look, get down in here and see what's here. Try not to take a ride. work our way down in here. These shards through here still. So we're going to work down here. There's where we're going to head to is there. Going to come this way. Work our way back down here. I tell you, the old lakes, the going down part is the hard part. So we're going to reverse this out.
Go back up and come down over here.
Right over there?
Yeah, I'll go over where I came down.
Well, we're going to try to figure out a different way down here. So as I was going over there, Maria spotted from over there with the glasses the spectacular circle over there. And then John went down to this lower level, which is pretty hairy. But we're going to go down there and take a look at what he saw down there, which is incredible. So we're going to come down this cliff right here and work our way down. We're going to definitely take our time because, man, I'm telling you what, you wouldn't want to tumble down this by no means. So we're going to get down in here, work our way down this ledge wall, and go from there. About lost my water, and then go down there. So here we are right here. We've come from up here, going in. You know, we need looking in all these crevices as well. Because I tell you what, you never know what's going to be down in here. Now, on that wall over there, what we've seen is we've seen petroglyphs. So what I like about this is I truly believe that we are in a very unique location that very few people have seen. I think we're walking into something that is really going to be incredible. So all we got to do is make sure that we get good footing right here. If we don't go forward, I'm just going to go on my butt down. The last thing we want to do is pop off. And so we're going to look in here. So here's what we got. Now here's the scary part. This grass that you see that's dead is like lightning slick. Man, it is unbelievably slick. So I'm going to take my time, work my way across this panel. I see an animal over here, so let's work our way, and we see more over here. Now, if we had the time and the energy, it would probably be pretty incredible to do this whole cliff edge. But, you know, we definitely have found something that's pretty incredible on this side. I'm going to take my time and work over here. Okay, look at that animal right there. So we've got a cool animal over here. So look at that. That is really neat. And look what we're hanging off of right here. You know, I'm wondering if there's another level that we can even go down even further. But what we're going to do is take a look at this right here, which is really, really neat. Oh my gosh. Okay, we've seen the petroglyph. I caught a glimpse. Man, I'm so pumped up. I'm telling you what. As I looked around this corner, right here, we see this one. But there's some type of animal, lizard, something like that, over here. So let's work our way up these rock walls. Oh my gosh. Look at that lizard. That is absolutely incredible. Stuck in behind here. Look at that. Look at that shot right there. Isn't that unbelievable? Look at that. Wow. That was worth the climb down. And that's something these are. Look at the small one here. There's a large one and there's a small one. Wow, how incredible is that? You know, I was going to come down that way. That would have been fairly hairy if I'd originally went down that way. But how neat is that? Look at that picture right there. That is a cool petroglyph right there. Let's look our way back over here. Wow. Like a mountain goat right there. And then right here, I want to get these branches back because I don't want it scraping that rock art right there. So I'm going to trim that back a little bit. Keep that off of there. Keep them scratching on there. There we go. How cool is that thing? I'm just wondering what else could be stuck in here. This is such an incredible place. You know, this is, You know when you're in these secret areas that you just know that this was a special location? You know, it looks like it dead ends. Let's go under there to make sure there's nothing over there. And then let's walk over here and see what's up here. That's pretty hairy for anybody. Now let's look up in here and see if there's anything in there. I don't see anything. I don't see anything over there. Look at that right there. That ain't comfortable, even for me. I'm glad I got a big rock. Now let's work our way back over there and then see what's over there. But I'm telling you what, those two petroglyphs there, this is in this remote location that you've just, and it wouldn't have been for that circle over there, which is spectacular. I'd have never even thought about there could be anything down here. So let's work our way back over here. Now I'm gonna tell you what gets me uncomfortable. This right here, this grass out here is ridiculously slick. And you know, even though that's kind of hairy over there, if you fell down, it wouldn't be a good day. This stuff here is unpredictable. And then when you got to work with little areas like that, it's really, really uncomfortable. These areas right just like this, because you could slide sideways and be down that cliff canyon wall. And we're not playing in this location. This location is pretty serious. So that's what makes this so intriguing to me, is that you feel like you're looking in places that not a lot of people have been. Oh man, look at this. Okay, here we go. Look at these pets right here. You know, these, like I said, what makes these so incredible to me is that it's not stuff that I think a lot of people have got the opportunity to see. So when I see this stuff, you know, I really feel very fortunate that we're looking at things that not a lot of people have had the opportunity to see. These are pretty special. Look at this dude here. I love these circles. It's incredible. Let's work our way over here. I don't know what that is there. There's a man right there. Look at these walls. They don't even seem real. I mean, they really don't. If you walk through this, there's where we came from. There's the cliff edge that we're hanging off of, which is not fun. We're working over here to these ones over here. And I don't know if there's another ledge that I can get down to see those. Look at that point over there. Isn't that crazy? Now there's a nice little section of them right here. Right there with those. I don't know a way to get over there though. I don't know if there's a. Now we're in the weeds now, and we're in sticker bushes. Definitely want to make sure that we keep an eye out on these rock ledges for other predators. That's gonna not, there's those ones over there. Pretty unbelievable right there. How crazy is that? Look around for anything else that could be possibly down there. I'm trying to see if there's another level that we can get to as far as going down and getting down one more level safely. I'm gonna pop over here and give you guys extension, stand in these sticker bushes and see if I can't get at least a little closer to what we got right there. But we're seeing some stuff that the average person is not going to see. Definitely increase the interest of the area to me. Now my thought is there a way to get to a level down one more? And we're not going to take a chance on sliding down that next level, because the next level is the next level is the next level. And there might be a way to get in here over here. It's actually a pretty good drop right there. That don't look bad right there. Getting over there is more critical or difficult than it looks like the climb is. like that, and I don't like that. But I got a pretty good shot of them right here. So, you know, if I don't have to get down there, you know, there ain't no reason to get down there. Now, I do like one thing I'm seeing right here. If I put my foot here and I get right here, I feel pretty good right there. That's where I feel good, right there. I don't feel good any closer, but I feel pretty good right here. So take a look at that. Those are really nice right there. So I don't know what the animal is with the circle around it. That's kind of really interesting. And over there, but I feel like I'm in a place that's fairly decent. I just wish if I felt a little more comfortable going down this ledge right here, you know, and I probably could make it, but the other side of the coin is I don't see anything over there, but I'd kick myself in the ass if there was something around that corner that I missed. But man, you were flirting with disaster down there. You were flirting with disaster. Because that's all I think we got anyway. I do not see anything else. This rock here is the critical rock that I get a hold of because I know it'll hold me. And so instead of taking that way, which I think is good, I'm going to go put my foot right there. If I act like I'm walking kind of gingerly, it's because of this grass. This grass is ridiculous. I don't see any other way down there to get around any of the rest of this. I believe they came down this route here and then to this point here. That circle's a big deal. That circle's one of the biggest deals, I think, out here. That's a supernova type deal. I mean, that had a lot of meaning. And if you look at those rocks right there, you can tell that they came down there. So they frequent this point a lot. Now, I can't get close to it, but there is a design right there. And I think there's other designs on this wall here. I can't get down there. But I'm telling you what, this was a really unbelievable location. Look at the circle. It's been chipped in here. You can see that. That's actually been chipped in, which is really pretty cool. So we went across. Now again, there is a brown panel. You can hardly see it. You're just going to have to trust me. And there's another brown panel up there. I don't know if that's got Petros on it, but that one does. So what my thought is, you know, again, these people lived, they lived and were born on this mountain. So going up and down this hill wouldn't have been anything to them. It would have just been a normal day, like walking on top. And so, you know, I imagine if you studied this whole mountain, what you would find is you would find petroglyphs all the way down here. Now, one thing that fascinates me is that structure down there, because that structure down there, it has some type of meaning. I can just tell it. You can just sometimes feel that this mountain, this cliffside had an immense meaning to the people here. I think this is my elevator up, and there's where I got to go. Through here, and this again is why you're so happy that your shoes grip and that you just take your time, you get up here and you work your way up. And again, since I'm taking you guys, it does make it a little more difficult, but that is the way it is. And again, for every crack I put my hand in, I'm making sure that it's accounted. We're going to take our time and make sure that we put our feet on all the right places, because there ain't no reason to slip now. Tell you what, now that I got my hands free, it makes this a hell of a lot easier. You always want to make sure you know where you're putting your hands. Don't know what kind of visitors you're going to get into up here. Well, that was fun and easy. So what a great find that was down there. What a great day. Man, don't get any better than this. Look at this out here. You know, as we're standing here, what I wanted to see was, did they come down the way on the point? Now, there goes back to the theory of the predator spot. If you look down on that rock right there, you're not going to be able to see it, but there's an upside down animal right there on that precarious rock. That's going to get a precarious. And then, but I think what they did was not hairy. I think what they did was they came over here and it looks like there's a path. Now, they're from here, So their path work is going to be better than mine. I'm not even going to think about taking a chance, but I do want to get a great shot of that circle from down here. But I do want to look and see if there's any areas that they could have slipped down here easier. Now they just didn't, they didn't pop in from over there. They could have came from this rock here. Now here's a crazy, that looks like a petroglyph right there. Right there on that point. But I'm going to guarantee you what they did was they worked around that point down. And I don't think that was nearly as hairy as it looks like it might be. But I really believe that that's what they did. They came across this rock here. And then they worked their way over around this point right here. I really believe that's what they did. Just stuck their feet and they went around this way. From over here, over to here, and then down to there. Which really is not that bad, really. Nearly look at it. There it is right there. So they popped in right there. That's how they came down here. And that's really not that bad. I don't see any reason to get down in there today. But let's see if this thing has got. Now this really isn't that bad. Because actually, I feel more comfortable right here than I did over there. But I'm not going to work my way back down in here and get crazy on this. But I am going to work to this rock right here. And that's it. Now, they walked right down in here and worked down. So that's all they did. And again, you know, this isn't nearly as hairy as coming through there. Because these rocks, I feel comfortable with the platform that I'm on. Now, here's what I wanted to see. This is the craziest petroglyph. I don't even know what that is, but that is incredible. That is absolutely, that's a different petroglyph than I've seen. It kind of goes along with this right here, I believe. You know, and so how crazy is that? I don't know how well you guys can see that, but that is incredible. So I did get over here to see that one. I don't know what you guys are going to be able to see with this. There's what I'm looking at. And there's that circle. Isn't that incredible? That is unbelievable. So, you know, what we're going to do is, man, we're hanging off here today. And I hope the climb up there is better than the climb down was. The good news is I don't have to look down when I'm climbing up. The good news is when I get up here, I'm actually looking up and I'm not looking down, which is good. Other than what you see me doing right there. But my camera's falling apart, but I got to figure out a way to get up here, up on this rock right here, and then pull my way up. So you guys aren't seeing this. You're seeing the crazy shit. But I get everything I needed. Okay. Whew. Here's where we were. I think we can call today a day. And what an awesome look at this. We killed this thing today. Well.
Hey, you know, I'm all over this video. All over it.
Hey, is there any rocks that's been underwater?
I haven't seen underwater rocks yet. But I know I'm all over this video.
Well, what a day to put in the books. New Boots is in the books. We found a location that wasn't what we thought it would be. But then we saw petroglyphs that, man, pretty special deal. Pretty incredible. And wow, how incredible was that? You know, that we took this journey today. What a journey this was too. My gosh, you want to talk about being out in the middle of nowhere. Look at that. You know, I want to thank all my patrons, because without them, these journeys would be even more difficult. And I appreciate it. And if you'd like to be a Patreon subscriber, then go to Patreon and pick whatever plan that you makes sense to you. And please tune in for our live shows every Tuesday. And what an incredible, incredible journey we've been on. And I'm pretty excited about the future of the channel. You know, it sounds like we're gonna get some affiliates that are gonna come aboard that we can, you know, get more information, do some collabs with, expand our channel, expand the knowledge, expand the education. So I'm really excited about that. So I appreciate everybody, and stay safe, and I'll see you down the road, amigos. He's not smarter than I am. I can get him. You can. There he is. In a different day, the outcome might have been a lot different than today. Kids, don't smoke 3 packs of cigarettes a day. Unless you're drinking yourself into oblivion. That's okay. You know, if you like this channel and you've watched this much of it, then you either like it or you're insane. But either way, please subscribe. Please give me a thumbs up and hit that notification bell. What that does is tell you every time I put out a video. It's getting a little sporadic. I still try to do 2 a week. Look at that guy right there. Is that a biplane? Yeah! What movie is this? What movie is this? What movie? Never mind, it wasn't a biplane. It's a good thing I'm not out here stuck, because he wouldn't have come and got me.